Hey, it's Corey Glover from Living Color. Right now, I'm going to Mira Sushi, and I'm gonna go cook with Chef Brian. Watch this.
Corey.
Hey.
Welcome.
How's it going, Brian?
This is a very special episode because this is the first episode we're doing at the sushi bar.
Ooh.
Yeah. So let's get to it.
I like sushi.
So what I have prepared for you today is a spicy salmon crispy rice sushi. So it, it just combines some of my favorite things, salmon being one of them.
Mine too.
You know, anything deep fried is always better.
Always good.
Always awesome,
always
right? First thing we got to do is prepare the crispy rice element.
Okay.
So we are going to take some sushi rice.
Right.
And these are non-stick sushi gloves, all right?
Specific gloves for this purpose.
Yes, specific gloves, because if you wear regular like vinyl or latex gloves, the rice will stick all over.
Right.
1 quart of sushi rice, right. Specifically sushi rice, to 1.25 quarts of water. That's the exact recipe I always use.
Okay, right.
And we just lightly pressed it.
Right.
And now we're gonna lift this up. And we have now a rice block formed.
Excellent.
Okay, and we're just gonna rest it on this plate and put it into the fridge because we actually want this to solidify a little bit.
Oh, okay, so you want to harden a little bit.
Exactly, okay. Before we put it into the fryer, otherwise it's gonna just fall apart.
Right.
We take these salmon scraps.
Right.
Can you give me some motivation and maybe some growls and screams while I chop at this? It'll make me cut faster.
Watch. There you go, see?
Oh my God, it's almost done. Our salmon's nice and chopped up.
Right.
Okay. We're gonna take this bowl right here.
Mm-hmm.
Just throw that salmon inside. Big pinch of scallion.
Yeah.
And a big pinch of masago, which is fish roe.
Right.
Here we have some Japanese kupi mayonnaise,
mm-hmm.
which is a bit more tart and thicker than your average American mayonnaise. So this is some sesame oil. We're just gonna add in
grease. Always gotta have grease.
Always makes it better.
Grease makes everything better.
I only added in about a quarter of that.
Okay.
I'm gonna add in all this sriracha.
Of course.
Want it nice and spicy. And we're gonna add in all this honey for sweetness.
Nice.
To counterbalance that heat.
Right.
Just gonna mix that up. So now we have a cohesive mixture. And we're gonna take some of this and place it right into the spicy salmon. But you don't wanna add too much. You just want enough to kind of bind everything together.
Right.
Now we're gonna take this serrano chili and just cut it into 6 nice, small, thin slices.
Right.
Now we're gonna get our crispy rice, which was in the fryer.
Okay.
We got it nice and crispy. And we're going to top it with some spicy salmon that we just made. And we just wanna put a nice, even layer
right
on top. We're gonna cut it. So we're gonna cut it in half first.
Right.
And then into thirds. And we're just going to kind of offset these. Take our spicy mayo that we just made, drizzle it on top. We're gonna take some unagi sauce.
Okay.
Do the same thing. Each piece with our serrano chili. Finish off the dish with some marinated ginger. Okay. And here we have the spicy salmon crispy rice sushi.
Oh yeah. That's good. That's really good.
Thanks, man. That entire dish is for you.
Oh, for me?
Yeah.
No, well, you know. Goodbye.
That's it. That's all for today's episode. All right, Corey. So you've seen me make the dish. You're still tasting the dish. I'm going to head out of here, and you are going to have to recreate this for me now. You ready?
No.
See ya.
All right, folks. Now I got to do this. Don't get excited because it's not going to be pretty.
Living Color's music encompasses so many genres. You know, you guys draw from so much. And as a chef, I try to do the same thing,
right.
Is draw from different inspirations. Being that your band's so eclectic, how do you keep it eclectic? Or is that even a consideration? Do you kind of let it happen?
We let it happen, but sometimes you have to balance certain things out. It's like, you know, each of us has our own sort of like, our own kink,
mm-hmm.
you know? Somebody likes really avant-garde jazz, somebody likes really like Aboriginal music from various different places. Some of us, you know, are trying to get into some emotional spaces, mm-hmm. and all those things sort of like, each fourth sort of makes it the whole thing work. So Vernon wants to take it out into some weird key signature and something like that, and I wanted to say something, and Doug wants to keep a solid sort of groove thing, and Will found some beat that he found in Burundi a couple weeks ago, and he wants to add that to it.
Yeah.
It turns out to be Living Color.
It just happened naturally as the band formed?
As we go along, like, we'll play a song, and then all of a sudden, somebody says, okay, so let's do this. Let's change this around. Mm-hmm. And sometimes each of us sort of delve into each other's sort of bag, but for the most part, we know not to settle on one thing. Mm-hmm. I mean, even after we recorded the song, or even after we played it for years, that it'll change. Mm-hmm. It's like, okay, tonight let's do it in drop D tuning and see how that feels.
Wow, just like that, like you guys will
think about it. Yeah, it's like, and it'll change. It's like, okay,
oh wow,
okay, let's do it.
Changing something the night of is kind of scary.
It is scary, and we fuck it up a lot. We do, but we have a good time doing it, mm-hmm. you know. And that's that spirit of that experimentation, I think, that we are looking for. We like trying to expand the idea of the music, mm-hmm. and expand the idea of what we're trying to convey in a certain thing. Like on this album thing, before we put out the album, we did a version of Biggie Smalls' Who Shot You.
Yes.
Who Shot You was something, I am from Brooklyn. I am a major Biggie fan. I think he was the preeminent lyricist of his time, mm-hmm. and of his day. We just thought that, you know, with what's going on in America, at least, and the rising of gun violence, and the idea of that we live in a gun culture that is prevalent in everything. Like, everybody's answer to anything is get a gun, mm-hmm. you know. And for like the African American community, it's really, really, people being shot is at an epidemic proportion, as far as I can see. We didn't say, okay, I want it to sound like this, I want to do this, I want to do that. It was like, let's just play it.
Yeah.
And it sounded, and that's the way it sounded that way. Yeah. When the four of us got together and said, okay, I'm going to do it like this, that's the way it sounded. Vernon found some strange guitar sound, and you know, Will had a beat that was particular to that, and you know, it's, and we all sort of like put our two cents in it, and it came out really, really interesting. Yeah. And emotionally, what I think the song gets to is not as much about the bravado of having a gun, but the melancholy of what a gun is, because mm-hmm. you don't have, you know. If you got a gun, you got problems. Are you going to find a problem for a gun?
Yeah. All right, Corey. So you've seen me make the dish, and this is your replication of it.
No, it's not. But this is what I thought it looked like.
I definitely have some criticisms from first glance. Plating is quite different from mine.
Yeah.
The plate is
offset.
Offset, and it's also very dirty around the edges, not something we'd typically want to serve our customers here.
Right.
Chili's cut a little big, and there's still some big chunks of, did you scream while you cut?
No, I wasn't screaming, but I was singing to myself.
Spicy salmon's good though.
Oh, good.
Yeah. The flavor's good. The sauce tastes great.
Oh, good.
Spicy mayo is right on point. Presentation-wise is definitely where it's lacking. Would you like
I'm just going to scratch my head as to what the hell it is I did here.
I mean, it just looks slightly different from mine.
Slightly?
Slightly. Out of 10, Corey, keeping into account that flavor-wise, it's pretty darn good, very close to what I made. Although your twitches are saying otherwise, actually. Visually, though, it's, you know, you have these two opposing things. So I'm going to have to give this a 6.5 out of 10. So
passing.
And, you know, that's half the battle. So, Corey, thank you very much for being on Taste of Metal.
Thank you, man.
And I'm looking forward to see you guys playing live soon.
You will. We'll be around.